Tesla's Elon Musk just confirmed that Tesla's 4680 battery cells will be used for other purposes as well, besides powering Tesla's electric vehicles. What are the uses? Well, there is an interesting piece of information that I want to share with you, and I'm about to do that. So during his speech last night to Gigafactory Nevada employees about the facility's $3.6 billion expansion, Tesla CEO Elon Musk dropped a very interesting tidbit of information. The company's 4680 battery cells would not just be used for electric cars. They would eventually be used for Tesla Energy's battery storage productions as well, for those products as well. This is good news, because in order to make an announcement like this, Tesla must have 4680 mass production solved. Let's face it, no one in the automotive industry has been able to catch up with Tesla since it opened its doors. The big question for me is, how long will it take the rest of the automotive industry to get where Tesla is today? What do you think? Let me know in the comment section below. Anyway, so Musk shared the information after stating that the upcoming 4680 plant in Giga Nevada could reach as much as 500 gigawatt-hour long term. But even such an impressive number, Musk noted, is but a step forward. Eventually, the CEO explained that Tesla is looking to produce well over 1,000 gigawatt hours. Years ago, when Tesla said Giga Berlin's battery factory would be the largest battery factory in the world, it was up to 250 to 300. Now we're talking 500 gigawatt hour. As Tesla became more and more proficient with this battery production, Musk hinted that 4680 cells would be used by the company in more products, as such battery storage products like the Megapack and the Powerwall home batteries, or other energy storage devices that the company may release in the future would also be using 4680 cells. So Tesla will take the 4680 cells and put them in Powerwalls and Megapacks. Musk said, "We expect the new cell factory to produce at least 100 gigawatt hours, and that's really just to begin with. Long term, Tesla is aiming to produce well over 1,000 gigawatt hours, possibly 2,000 or 3,000. So this really is just the start, and that's equivalent of 1.5 million additional Model 3 and Model Y vehicles, and will also be using 4680 for stationary storage as well. And to be clear, this is an addition to our suppliers," Musk said yesterday. Friends, Elon Musk's comment about Tesla Energy products using 4680 cells is very interesting. Why? This is because products such as the Megapack are expected to utilize LFP batteries, which are different from the NCM 811 cathode chemistry used in Tesla's current generation 4680 cells. Considering Musk's confirmation that 4680 cells would be used for Tesla's stationary storage in the future, then it would seem that EV maker would also be producing 4680 cells with different chemistries. That's another interesting factor about this. Tesla's relatively recent announcement of its new 4680 battery cells has sent shockwaves through the electric vehicle industry. These new cells, which are named after their diameter 46 millimeter and length 80 millimeter, are not only larger and more energy dense than their previous versions, but they also have the potential to significantly decrease the cost of production for Tesla cars. That means in the future, we may see cheaper or discounted Tesla cars. One of the most significant aspects of these new cells is their energy density, which is the amount of energy that can be stored in a given volume or mass. The 4680 cells have an energy density of up to 5 times higher than Tesla's previous 2170 cells, which means that they can store more energy in a smaller space, which is important for vehicles. This means that Tesla will be able to produce cars that have a longer range and can travel further on a single charge. This is particularly important for electric vehicles, as range anxiety is one of the biggest concerns for potential electric vehicle buyers. And now Tesla says they're increasing the production of 4680 and their use. Another significant aspect of 4680 cells is their cost. Tesla has stated that these new cells will be cheaper to produce than their previous versions. This is because they are made of a new type of material called NCA, nickel cobalt aluminum, which is cheaper and more abundant than the NMC, nickel manganese cobalt, used in the current 2170 cells, which 2170 is the size. This will allow Tesla to decrease the cost of production and ultimately the price of their electric vehicles, making those cars more accessible to the average consumer. This is a game changer for the industry as a whole, in my opinion. It means that Tesla will be able to produce cars that are not only more efficient and have longer range, but also more affordable for the average consumer. Because even today that Tesla has lowered the prices to $55,000, they're still not affordable for most people. This could lead to a massive increase in the adoption of electric vehicles, which is crucial for reducing our dependence on fossil fuels and fighting climate change. Electric vehicles emit less CO2 and other pollutants than traditional gasoline or diesel cars and are thus considered a more sustainable form of transportation. But it's not just the environmental benefits that make these new Tesla battery cells so significant. They also have the potential to create jobs and stimulate economic growth. As Tesla and other companies begin to adopt these new cells, there will be a need for more research and more development, as well as an increase in production and manufacturing. This will create new opportunities for workers in a variety of fields, from engineering to manufacturing. It also means that Tesla will be able to produce cars in a shorter period of time, leading to more revenue and more investment in the company. By the way, that's why Tesla announcing this new expansion of Gigafactory in Nevada will create 3,000 additional jobs. Overall, Tesla's 4680 battery cells are a major step forward in the electric vehicle industry. They have the potential to revolutionize the way we think about the used electric cars and its the use of the electric cars, and it's exciting to see what the future holds for this technology. And the 4680 cells will be used in Tesla's Cybertruck, Tesla Semi and Roadster models, as well as the upcoming Model S and Model X refresh. The company also plans to use them in its solar products, further expanding their reach. With the increasing demand for electric vehicles and with the release of the 4680 cells, Tesla is positioning itself to be at the forefront of the industry. Tesla's plan to build a new 100 gigawatt-hour 4680 cell factory with the capacity to produce enough batteries for 2 million electric light-duty vehicles annually is a significant step forward for the company and the industry as a whole. The new factory will greatly increase Tesla's production capacity, allowing the company to produce more electric vehicles and meet the growing demand for sustainable transportation. And to conclude, the 4680 cells will be more energy dense and cost effective, as I said, than previous battery cells, which will further drive down the cost of electric vehicles and make them more accessible to people. This move also highlights Tesla's commitment to investing in research and development, creating more jobs to improve battery technology and reduce the environmental impact of electric vehicles. Overall, Tesla's new factory is a positive development that will help accelerate the transition to a more sustainable transportation system. Let me know, friends, what do you think about Tesla using the 4680 batteries, not only for the vehicles, but also other energy storage systems that may end up in your garage. This is Armin Haria from TorqueNews.com. God bless you. Give us thumbs up if you found this report helpful, useful, and informative for your decision making. And I'll see you soon in our next report. Let's continue the discussion in the comment section below.